Hello, everyone. My name is Tim Mickleborough, and today I'm presenting a virtual paper poster entitled Reproducing Whiteness in Healthcare Spaces, a Spatial Analysis of the Critical Literature on the Integration of International Healthcare Professionals. So despite the appearance of diversity, internationally educated healthcare professionals report inequities in the workplace. A spatial analysis of the critical literature on IEHP integration addresses three gaps in knowledge. First, addresses gaps in understanding how whiteness operates to reproduce social inequities. Second, there is a gap in understanding how globalization intersects with professionalizing systems to reproduce inequities between domestic and internationally trained professionals. Thirdly, we address a methodological gap by providing analytical tools that tie the global to the local in the microspaces of the professions. The methodological gap is addressed through a spatial analysis of the critical literature on IEHP integration. It's a conceptual framing that examines social issues through the concrete, whether it's a geographical area or a ward in a hospital. A spatial analysis problematizes the neutrality of space, and two theorists help frame the analysis. The first is Lefebvre, a spatial theorist who problematized the neutrality of space by reinserting social relations into the production of space. And Foucault, who investigated how space is situated within power-knowledge relations. Two spatial metaphors help conceptualize the social reproduction of space. The first is purity of space, which are elite spaces of white normativity that reproduce social privilege and differences that threaten homogeneity of pure space. And because space produces privilege identities and social status, they must be protected from outside influence. Related to purity of space is peripheral space. The purity of professional space is maintained through the construction of peripheral or alternative spaces, which act to eliminate but also contain difference. The spatial analysis of the critical literature identified four mechanisms that reproduce whiteness in healthcare spaces. Credential non-recognition operates as a professional closure mechanism. It protects the purity of professional space by eliminating different knowledge, which is constructed as a threat to the status quo. Resocialization is the second mechanism, and it demands that international professionals cast off their culture and adopt local specific discourses of Canadianness in order to gain professional legitimacy, thus reproducing white social cultural norms while subduing difference. The third mechanism is workplace racialization and spatialization. This produces peripheral spaces that organize difference into hierarchies that are highly racialized and gendered. For example, white English-speaking nurses occupy higher status positions that require more technical expertise, while international nurses, by comparison, are more likely to work in the periphery, such as in nursing homes, where the work is more routine, physically demanding, and less valued. Finally, surveillance determines who belongs to the space, and belonging requires having the right knowledge, producing Canadian universities, and speaking with an unmarked Canadian or white accent. Thus, knowledge produced in Canada and the Canadian accent become the yardstick to measure competence. In the discussion, we feel that reflexivity is important to recognize the differences between productive professionalism versus systemic marginalization. So regulatory bodies should apply credential non-recognition as a temporary measure to ensure patient safety and professional standards, so it does not become a permanent barrier to integration of IEHPs. Resocialization and adoption of Canadianness is required for professional legitimacy, but surveillance marginalizes IEHPs because of accents. Awareness of how linguicism disadvantages IEHPs should inform policy and efforts to support integration. While there's a role for hierarchy in the workplace, there is a need to problematize the disproportionate number of IEHPs working in the periphery in order to address racialization in the health professions workplace. In conclusion, spatial analysis makes whiteness visible, allowing for evidence-informed changes that can address systemic racism and discrimination in healthcare.